Good morning. I'm Dr. Narubed from Queen Sirikit Naval Hospital. I'm an orthopedic sports medicine doctor and also the diving medical officer of the Royal Thai Navy. So, it's not work. Click here. Okay, as a benefit of practicing in Naval Hospital, we have a great opportunity to access the modality called hyperbaric oxygen therapy. In a hospital, we have multiplex hyperbaric chamber available for 12 patients, including attendant, for taking care of patients during the diving operation. For the example case of mine, this is the compound distal tibia fracture. Severe soft tissue injury was suspected even after the external fixation. And waiting for the swelling to be subsided in a hospital, hyperbaric oxygen therapy was routinely used in such cases, both preoperatively and postoperatively. Before we get into the scientific data, we have to clarify that what is the hyperbaric oxygen therapy we're going to talk about today. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy must be systemic oxygenation under hyperbaric environment. So the topical oxygenation will not be included in this talk, and hyperbaric environment must be at least 1.9 atmosphere absolute. The current approved indications of hyperbaric oxygen therapy was listed by USMS in 2019. There are 14 indications as shown in the slide. Two main mechanisms is to reduce the first, we use this thing for treating diving accidents such as decompression sickness and the air gas embolism. So the two main mechanisms of HBO is to reduce the size of the gas in the body and to increase oxygen and dissolve in the plasma for washing out nitrogen gas in the tissue. And this oxygen is able to enhance the healing process of tissue that injured by the gas bubble. How could it be? In normal tissue, there is normal balance of oxygen tension between in bloodstream and the surrounding tissue. When tissue got injured, more oxygen was needed for the tissue healing. So this will cause vasodilation and increase capillary permeability to raise the oxygen transfer to the end organ. More tissue leakage will cause the more interstitial fluid and interstitial pressure. So this will decrease microcirculation due to the high interstitial pressure, and it end up with more tissue swelling and more tissue injury. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy will increase the oxygen tension in the vessels and cause vasoconstriction itself. So the oxygen, more oxygen dissolve in the plasma will exceed the tissue oxygen demand, so it will not cause any further damage. Reducing in the fluid leakage will reduce the interstitial pressure, so the swelling will be subside because there is no need for vasodilation to raise the oxygen transfer. Because all of injured tissue is compromised by any cause of trauma, and the compromised tissue demanded more oxygen for tissue healing. That's why every injured tissue is relatively ischemia and sometimes even hypoxic. And oxygen was proven to be an important factor of tissue healing in many processes of every phase, from inflammatory phase to the remodeling phase. So based on that basis, there were studies trying to prove this anti-inflammatory effect of HBO. This study investigator simulated fever in rabbits and checked their inflammatory cell markers. The result was quite impressive. HBO was able to reduce interleukin 6 and PGE 2 level in the febrile rabbit. Next is the clinical study using HBO in the patients underwent brain tumor surgery. The results show that HBO was able to significantly reduce the level of TNF-alpha and interleukin-6. There also was the systematic review of using HBO in inflammatory bowel disease. many inflammatory biomarkers were collected, and the result showed that HBO was able to reduce most of the serum biomarkers in subject body. For the inflammation in athlete, there was randomized control trial of using HBO in acute ankle sprain compared between 16 patients using HBO at 2.0 ATA and 16 patients using normal baric oxygenation. Although most of the clinical results was not significantly different, but for the functional outcome in treatment group was significantly better. In another non-randomized comparative study, 16 rugby players who suffered from grade 2 MCL injury was sent for SBOT at 2.8 ATA as a treatment group. Pain score of treatment group was significantly better, and the treatment group experienced significantly faster return to play time compared to the control group. For delay onset muscle soreness or DOMS, there was Cochrane review in 2005. Four trials were included into the pool data. All of the parameters, including pain, swelling, and muscle strength, were not significantly improved after using SBOT, but be noting that all of the studies creating DOMS by using exercise program in lab only. This may not represent DOMS or of the professional athlete experience in the real games. There was systematic review and meta-analysis of using SBOT to enhance the recovery and performance in athletes. 10 studies were included in this review, and only 6 studies were included in the meta-analysis. And all 4 studies using SBOT during the exercise only available for systematic review, not meta-analysis. As the result of the meta-analysis to evaluate the performance, there were results of the blood lactate concentration, peak heart rate, rating of perceived exertion or RPE. To evaluate the recovery, there were the result of biological antioxidant potential, CK and LDH. Both pre-exercise and post-exercise HBOT was not shown any significantly different, but for the intra-exercise HBOT, the results show improvement in muscle endurance power in systematic review. Again, most of this exercise is due in the lab only. That's why even most of the studies were able to prove the homogeneity of HBOT results in sports practice, but anyone who can access this modality would try it, even in the chance of very little difference, because in the major tournament, this may affect the final result of the games. Most of the sports institute, including Thailand, HBOT was available for their athletes for enhancing recovery and improved healing condition. Multiple hyperbaric chamber of Navy was sometimes host for the recovery of professional athletes in group. And hyperbaric oxygen therapy was also safe for doping issue, as it's not in the WADA prohibited list. The main reason is that there was no strong evidence proof the HBOT result in significant improvement of the athlete performance. Until then, we can use it safely. So until we have more evidence, theoretically, HBOT was result in collection of tissue ischemia, enhancing the healing process and anti-inflammation effect. Few clinical data was available up to date. Not much strong evidence, but it trend to be beneficial for athletes in terms of recovery and performance enhancement. As a little effect, most of professional athletes need it. Difference may not be statistically significant, but in the match of very close competitors' performance, This little difference may act as a game changer, so it's not bad to try it. Thank you very much.